Grace and peace to you, my friends, in our Lord Jesus Christ. I bring you greetings from your friends and servants in the office of the General Assembly of the Evangelical Presbyterian Church. If we've not met before, my name is Dean Weaver, and I'm honored and privileged to serve you as our stated clerk. And I'm joined today by my good friend and colleague, Pat Coelho, who's our Chief Financial Officer. The two of us are together here to talk with you, just to maybe share a word as we come to the end of what is our fiscal year in the EPC. And Pat, as our Chief Financial Officer, could you explain to people what a fiscal year is and how it operates for us in the EPC?
Sure. So we have the calendar year. Obviously, everybody is aware of the calendar year. The fiscal year is just using the same 12 months, but we're starting with a different period. So for us, it's July 1st through June 30th. And it just makes it easier from an accounting perspective.
So our budget will start after General Assembly on the 1st of July, which means we're coming to the end of our fiscal year this year.
That's correct.
And as many of our congregations do, whether you run on a calendar year or a fiscal year, as you come to the end of the year, you start taking a good look at your finances. And I invited Pat here so he could share with you how we're doing, both in terms of the income that we've received, which is principally through something called per member asking, and how we're doing in terms of our revenue. So could you give us just a quick summary on coming down the home stretch of our fiscal year, how we're doing on income and expenses?
Sure. So for PMA, we're running about 4% behind budget. And we've seen that coincide with Russia's invasion of Ukraine. We've seen a drop in our revenue from that time frame.
And the rise of inflation.
And the rise of inflation has definitely been having an impact, that's for sure, in the expense side. But we've been able to control our expenses, fortunately. But, you know, the other side of that is we haven't been able to do everything that we'd like to accomplish because our revenue isn't quite where we'd like it to be.
That's exactly right. I appreciate that, Pat. Pat is such an excellent steward over our finances, and whether it's our annual auditing process or his ever watchful eye, we can tell you that we are great stewards of the resources invested in the kingdom work of the EPC. And whether it's the 20% of your per member asking that right off the top goes to our global partners in world outreach, or whether it's investing in church planting, or it's in investing in things like church health and evangelism, all of that money is accounted for wisely. And while we're spending even more wisely, we would love to be able to fully live into the mission that we have for the EPC. And so we're hoping as we come to the end of this fiscal year, your congregation might be able to take a look at where you stand and your contributions to the EPC and help us to finish the year strong. Pat, one of the other things about giving this year is that we've seen a terrific rise in benevolence giving towards disaster relief, whether it's the hurricane relief and tornadoes and wildfires here in the U.S., or whether it's the more recent Ukrainian crisis. Do you think there's any possibility that we see some people giving so generously to those funds, and maybe that's hurting us a little bit on the operational side?
I think that's a logical assumption to make. Yeah, for sure. And I think, too, one thing that's good for us to be aware of is that when you do give to the EPC, indirectly, you're giving to those efforts as well, because we're all about investing in church planting, church health, and world outreach.
Right. So I guess what we're hoping is that as we come to the close of the year, you'll see your per member askings as an important priority for each of your congregations, because we cannot continue to serve you at the high level that we have, whether it's in disaster relief or whether it's in the daily operations of Pat answering the phone call. What is it? You had a phone call from someone the other day who asked you for help in doing what?
Yeah, they had gotten a large donation. They put that donation into a mutual fund, but they weren't sure how to record the transaction on the books.
So we have a CFO who answers the phone calls of any one of our 637 congregations who call and have questions like that. So those kind of resources, that kind of help, those things are all made possible just because of your generous contributions. So please help us end the year strong. And remember that the Lord loves a cheerful giver, including cheerful giving congregations. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. From the Office of the General Assembly, the Pat and Dean Show, thanking you all very much for your love of the Lord in the EPC. Grace and peace to you.